conservative treatment, articular congruity, and the glenoid fractures are the ones which need surgery. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Right. Thank you.
We call Dr. Ram Chidambaram for his talk, Keeping Out of Trouble in Elbow Instability Surgery.
It's okay. Good afternoon. Okay, we're ready, right? So it's how to keep out of trouble in elbow instability surgery. I just split up this, so I'm just going to talk about the unstable elbows associated with the fracture. So I got my training in elbow surgery from none other than Sean Woodriscoll from Mayo Clinic and my mentor Daniel Mock. I just always thank them because they give a big perspective to understanding the elbow. So let us see some case scenario. This is not completely theory. So it's a 40-year-old man. The index x-ray is this. 3D CT was done at the time by the surgeon and he had this surgery. So what went wrong? Radial head was excised, there was no ligament repair, transarticular K-wire, POP cost for 1 month. Is it the time? 6:50, I can stop with that timing. Okay, 2 years later, this is the current situation of ankylosed elbow. Nothing could be done. Okay, second, there's another disaster case presentation. 32-year-old lady after road traffic accident had this, what it looked like, a comminuted fracture proximal radial head. Surgeon did this. That is, an attempt at replacing the radial head, which failed. So the proximal radius cracked further. No ligament repair was possible. Joint is subluxed, unstable, POP cast, sent to me. What can we do? Nothing. Nothing now. Nothing will work. So please do no harm. The reason, you have to understand the anatomy of elbow better. So this is the primary static constraint is by the ulnotrochlear articulation, and there is one structure on either side, a laterally LUCL, which is connecting the collateral ligament laterally, that's called LUCL, and medially MUCL. So these two ligaments hold the elbow. The coronoid provides anterior buttress and is restrained to the posterior dislocation. But anatomy-wise, you have to remember, is the tip is intra-articular, has got no attachment either. The capsule is attached to 6 mm distal. So if you see a very tip, don't need to worry about anything. The brachialis insertion is further beyond with the capsule. The MCL is attached to the sublime tubercle, or what is called the andromedial tubercle of the coronoid facet. If that is fractured, you have to fix that. So the radial collateral ligament is a triangular configuration, which is combination of radial collateral ligament, LUCL, which is connecting the humerus and the ulna, and the annular ligament. So this is the combination that provides structural support on the lateral side. So remember this. Secondary dynamic constraint is by the radial head. This contributes to 60% of weight bearing of the elbow. So that's about anatomy. Let us see other cases and how I dealt with. So this is the 54-year-old man after road traffic accident coming to me like this. There's swollen elbow, small puncture wound on the medial side. So you could see that the radial head is broken and smashed somewhere down the line. So that is 3D CT scan. Unstable elbow, coronoid fracture, radial head fracture. You all know it's a terrible triad. How to go about it? Understand the anatomy again. This is a posterolateral instability. I will explain a bit further. When the patient falls with the axial load with the valgus component, the forearm gets into supination, put tremendous stress on opening of the lateral side of the elbow. So the first structure, first stage is the lateral collateral ligament rupture associated with the capsular tear. Second, it rotates. It rotates, pivots against the MCL, so the impaction fracture of capitulum or radial head and the coronoid tip fracture can happen at any level. Finally, the medial side also fails. So this is like a gory circle, it is described. So if you see the x-ray, don't miss the soft tissue injury that's not seen in the x-rays, which is LCL, MCL and muscle tear. So how I treat this terrible triad elbow? This is my principle. Number one, repair the lateral collateral ligament. It's a must. Number two, fix or replace the radial head here that will stabilize the elbow. Three, fix coronoid if displaced to fragment. If it is not displaced, you can leave it alone here. and check stability. If it is still unstable, repair the medial side. So radial fracture fixation is my first choice. Why I favor? Because always preserves bone anatomy. A repair of concomitant injury is possible. Chance of healing, even if it is fragmented, it can adapt. There is no overstuffing like a replacement. We have now a lot of choices. I use the headless compression screws. I use the radial head and rim plate. And I use also the hand surgery implants and instruments for this fixation. If not fixable, as a last resort, we go for radial head replacement. The reason is radial head morphology is complex with its offset. It is not reproduced reliably by any prosthesis available so far. And also it carries a high risk of complications. So coronoid fracture, you have to recognize the pattern and deal with that. This is the primitive classification many years ago, and it's been modified by Sean Wood-Driscoll to address the main focus is on the andromedial facet. So how to fix coronoid? If the radial head is fractured, you can approach through the fragment of the radial side. Or if you want to go medial side, you can go either over the common flexor origin or under the common flexor origin like this, andromedial or postromedial. So fixation method varies. There's a lot of options. We'll show each if it's possible. So what did I do for this case? So lateral approach. You could see the radial head fragment is separate. I just took it out, put it in the radial head as it belongs, and fixed it with screws and plate. Headless screws and rim and head plate. You see the movement. It should be able. You should be able to move it. Otherwise, you will not get good result. So then I proceeded with the lateral collateral ligament with a triple loaded anchor because we are a shoulder surgeon. And then the coronoid is fixed as well from posterior to anterior. So that is the range of movement on table because I mobilized them straight away in 2 days' time. And there is the next, you see supination pronation of the forearm. So if you see that, the coronoid here is fixed from posterior to anterior after reduction. And then the radial head is replaced. Replace means repositioned and fixed plate and screws, and that is the range of movement at 2 weeks. This patient was done operated 2 weeks ago. So let's see the another case, a 25-year-old lady after accident. This was operated 1 month ago. Again, terrible triad, and see the radial head fragment. I think the timer was set at seven minutes. I take 2-3 minutes. Okay, fine, thank you. So this is the 3D CT. You know this radial head is not fixable because it is smashed. If you fix it, you would not have stability to rotate it. So again, lateral approach, as soon as I put the skin incision, you see the bare lateral condyle, LCL, LUCL, everything is torn off from the distal humerus, and you could see the radial head fragments everywhere. So here, I use the radial head replacement. So you see, this is the radial head replacement. You have to use the correct size. You should not overstuff. You should be measuring the same size. And then, unfortunately, we don't have anatomic radial head available in India. We have only local companies that make it. But this is closer, better for trauma option. So that radial head, once you put, the elbow becomes stable. You see here, I'm just showing a screening of the elbow with the radial head replacement. No ligament repair even. The LCL repair is going to be done next. So the LCL repair is done. It is stable configuration. And then I assess antero-posteriorly, that is medial-lateral laxity. The MCL was torn and lax, so I repaired the MCL, that is medial collateral ligament. Now if you look at it, radial head is replaced, lateral collateral ligament repaired, medial collateral ligament repaired, so there is nothing to stop you moving the elbow, so we can start movement. So this is the third spectrum, with that I will close. It's a 23-year-old man, road traffic accident 2 months ago. 2 months ago, the right elbow was dislocated, he had native treatment, swollen elbow, painful, it's stuck like this. This is the presentation. You can see that. So he has got a coronoid fracture, which you could see that, dislocated, some early heterotopic ossification. That is the range of movement he has. Now, the patient came with the MRI scan, and you could see that damage everywhere. But note, the radial head is intact. With the coronoid fracture, with the dislocation, if the radial head is intact, this is a different pattern of injury. That is varus postromedial rotator instability. Here what happens, the lateral collateral ligament is torn, it pivots against the tubercle, the andromedial facet of coronoid. So the coronoid is broken. So the radial head is free to rotate, it causes further damage and dislocates. So that is why here the treatment line will be, first fix the coronoid. Second, repair the lateral side collateral ligament. Third, repair the middle collateral ligament if the elbow is still unstable. So this is my pattern of treating this. You can use the whatever choice of fixation for the coronoid. Here I have approached first medially, and I fix the coronoid with a plate and screw, which is the hand system plate. And that is a screening after coronoid fixation. You see how much stability that gives. Because here the problem is coronoid. So then I proceeded lateral approach. The collateral ligament and extensor origin was torn, and I repaired that as well. So this is the MCL repair and flexor origin repair finally. And that is the postoperative X-ray. Elbow is relocated. I never gone posteriorly. There is some atrotropic ossification. It's a bit dangerous to operate at 2 months on a post-traumatic elbow, but it is a dislocated, so I just took the chance and did that. But making sure that I can mobilize. If I put him in plaster again, he will develop a terrible atrotropic ossification. So he started mobilizing straight away 2 days post-operative, and that's him 2 weeks post-op. So that is 2 weeks post-op, he's able to eat, which he couldn't do for 2 months. So he's very happy. So that is him at 6 weeks post-operative, the coronoid has healed. I think, shall we finish? Yeah, okay, I think we have two more cases, but that's fine.